This program is brought to you by the Genesis Communications Network, a world leader in talk radio since 1998. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Welcome. Here we are in the age of Trump. The mainstream media is doing backflips, and we're going to talk about it today on The Stone Cold Truth. Welcome to the show. We're here on the Genesis Communications Network. A shout out to our friends at KRFE, the home station of Buddy Holly, right there in Lubbock. We love Lubbock. I've had the Lubbock experience. It's a great town. Also, my friends at 89.1 in Austin. Austin gets even weirder when I'm there. It's a great town. It's a great food town. It's a great drink town. And, of course, it is where the secret bunker of my friend Alex Jones is located. I am broadcasting today, however, from an undisclosed location in South Florida, very close to Miami. And in Miami, there is literally in places in Hialeah and other parts of Miami-Dade County, there are celebrations in the street because a dictator, a mass murderer, a war criminal, Fidel Castro, is dead. The mainstream media has always tried to write this story of Fidel Castro as some kind of revolutionary, utopian Robin Hood, when in fact he was just your garden variety thug trying to make communism or Marxism, a system that cannot economically survive, and exporting terrorism and other defilements against the United States. I'm going to talk later about Castro, because in my own case, I have, in a way, lived the Cuban experience. My wife, Nydia Bertrand Stone, is a Cuban-American, and her father, Joaquin Bertrand, was a Cuban diplomat stationed in Washington, D.C. at the time of my wife's birth. She lived in Cuba as a young girl, and she tells me she could, under Batista, hear men yelling from being tortured in the prisons. And at night, she could hear the sound of machine gun fire far off. And her father was a non-political civil service diplomat stationed in Washington. He was aware, of course, of the insurgency against Batista. The government fell, but in essence, Batista was removed, but the government structure remained in place with a new boss, El Jefe. My wife was on the cover of the Chicago paper because she was, as a child, photographed with one of the barbudo, the bearded ones, the band of revolutionaries who followed Fidel, and they were swaggering in public. They wore fatigues, they had beards, they smoked cigars, they laughed, they slapped women. They were stylish to some. And eventually, my father-in-law was ordered to return to Cuba for briefings. And he packed his bag. He wore a uniform. The night before he was to leave, there was a knock on the door where a friendly agent from the Central Intelligence Agency told him not to return to Havana because he was on a list of people to be liquidated. His life savings were in banks in Cuba. His home was in Cuba. He was serving his country. He's an educated man, a very handsome, mustached, unflappable, easygoing. But he was lost a life savings, and his command of English was not great. He was instantly indigent, and he worked as a house painter, and he worked as a fuller brush man, and he worked in a printing shop, and he worked to support my wife and her sister and my mother-in-law, who was a very tough and wonderful Cuban lady. So I've lived this experience. I've seen what Castro has wrought, and my father-in-law would move to Miami, and he would become acquainted with the Cuban right-wing anti-Castro underground, from which the Watergate burglars sprung, Bernard Barker, and Eugenio Martinez, still alive today. God bless you, sir. You're a patriot. To this day, we only recently learned through a declassified document that one of the Watergate burglars, the Cubans, said Martinez was in fact on the CIA payroll at the time of the Watergate break-in, which is how, further proof, I think McCord was a CIA guy as well, but it is how the agency was able to infiltrate the break-in and bring Nixon down. We have a terrific show today, and I really want to talk about whether Hillary should be locked up. I am a little disappointed initially when I heard when I read the transcript of the New York Times, but I also believe that perhaps Donald Trump is pardon insurance. Perhaps it's a signal. I think even Donald Trump would have to go where the evidence leads, and there's a lot of evidence that the 684,000 emails that 650,000 emails that were included in the Huma Abedin trove that were serious enough for FBI Director Comey to reopen the investigation, even though on the following Monday he announced there was nothing there, only after pressuring the NYPD, the New York Police Department, not to contradict him. You see, they have a copy of the documents and they know otherwise. In fact, my sources tell me that the Justice Department threatened to indict a number of officers in the Garner matter if they didn't stand down through Election Day. But the point up here is that we can't even catalog the crimes of the Clintons. It hasn't been done yet. The Clinton Foundation scam is a multi-billion dollar, many-layered scam that operated offshore and in the United States. I refer people to the work of Charles Ortel. That's O-R-T-E-L, Charles Ortel, at charlesortel.com, to unwind the extraordinary crimes here. So I am looking forward to getting Judge Napolitano on the show to tell us whether he thinks that the Clintons should yet and can yet be prosecuted. I think perhaps the president, I understand his notion for healing and the nature of that. But I am at the same time believe that we don't have all the evidence yet, and perhaps a judgment is premature. Stand by for the stone cold truth.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Roger Stone, New York Times best-selling author, brings you Nixon's Secrets. Nixon's Secrets shows how Hillary Clinton was fired from the 1974 Nixon Impeachment Committee staff for lying and violating Nixon's rights, and how Hillary tried unsuccessfully to block Nixon from the Clinton White House. No wonder Nixon, upon meeting Hillary for the first time, said, "She's cold. Cold as ice." Find out more at stonecoldtruth.com. In the New York Times best-selling book, The Man Who Killed Kennedy, The Case Against LBJ, Roger Stone has gathered documents and uses his first-hand knowledge to construct the ultimate book to prove that LBJ was not only involved in JFK's assassination, but he was in fact the mastermind. Find out how, and much more, in The Man Who Killed Kennedy, The Case Against LBJ. Get yours today at lbjkilledjfk.com.
This is Ben Gordon, and if your teeth are stained from coffee, tea, or smoking, Power Swabs is the answer. In 5 minutes, you'll see 2 shades whiter teeth, and in 7 days, 6 shades. There's no messy strips or trays that you have to leave in your mouth for an hour. Just swab your teeth for 5 minutes, and you're done. To try Power Swabs, call 1-800-290-8480. Your bright white smile will have your friends talking about how great you look. Try it risk-free. 1-800-290-8480. That's 1-800-290-8480.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24-7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Don't become dependent on the medical system. Get and stay healthy naturally with Extendivite. Metals in the liver cause peroxides to get dumped into the bloodstream. Peroxides do more damage than free radicals to the arteries, and the LDL has no protection from peroxides, causing the LDL to get stuck in the arteries, creating a potential blockage. Extendivite slowly chelates the metals away from the liver so it can dispose of what was meant to be a harmless process, peroxide. Extendivite's 7 herbs has a job to strengthen the organs and circulatory highway. Can you afford a heart attack? Extendivite is available in capsule or liquid form for just $69.95 for a 2-month supply. To get started, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822 or visit heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with
We use cell phones against our heads every day. But now, a landmark U.S. government study confirms increased health risks from exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The time to protect yourself is now. The solution is Defender Shield. Proudly made in the USA, Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation emitted from cell phones, tablets, and laptops. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. Use discount code DEFENDER for 10% off. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in EMF radiation protection.
Welcome back. We're broadcasting from the Stone Zone. We are surrounded by a room of, several rooms actually, in my bunker of political memorabilia, things that I have collected over the years in 9 presidential campaigns, and most of it framed. I've got to figure out what museum to leave this to at some point, but I also have an extensive connection of Nixoniana here with probably the largest single collection of Nixon campaign or pop culture related material, including anti-Nixon posters and so on, which at some point I'm going to put on display one time, perhaps for a short period of time in a gallery, just to see how these many positive and negative depictions of Nixon in pop culture are worth looking at. I need the time to curate it, I guess. But joining us now, Travis Irvine, a regular here in the Stone Zone, my favorite libertarian. He is a commando in the war for freedom, and he is always out there on the edge, trying to bring public awareness to the state and its efforts to steal our rights. He has been a candidate for Congress, a candidate for mayor. I like Teddy Roosevelt, like Dave Nixon. I like men who get in the arena, and he has. He is also notably a stand-up comic. Now, my producer, Frank Morano, who is helping, who is the king of all radio, despite his recent unexplained affinity for Chicago deep dish pizza, which has caused, as you might imagine, a small scandal on Staten Island, but that for another day. He has suggested that my introductions are too long, but until you have seen Travis Irvine's shtick when he's on a roll, you haven't lived. So, and it was Milton Berle who said, drama, that's easy. Comedy, now that's hard. Travis Irvine.
Roger, good to be with you as always. Happy Thanksgiving weekend. By the way, I would love to get as many of those Nixon posters and photographs and memorabilia whenever you're ready to start passing it on. I have had my eye on a lot of that stuff every time I come to visit. So, whenever you're ready to teach the millennial generation something about real conservatives, Nixon, Goldwater, Reagan, and pass along all that stuff, please put my name on the list.
Well, that's, I think, important because those are the roots of the movement that you are in. This all goes back to, goes back to Goldwater, goes back to William F. Buckley, Jr. It goes back to the classic actual effort by Bill Buckley and Bill Rusher and other enlightened conservatives to separate the conservative movement from anti-Semitism, anti-Catholicism, racial bigotry. I mean, there was a fever swamp in the conservative movement on the far, far right that perhaps in some places overlapped the John Birch Society, although in some most cases many of the John Birch Society members were decent, hardworking people who were concerned about communism, and frankly their concern was well-founded. But that's the tradition that you are now in, a new generation of freedom fighters. And while the movement has manifested itself largely within the Republican Party, it also manifests itself in the Libertarian Party, which is, has fielded the most credible ticket they have had to date, and has had strong showings in two elections. So give us the quick update on the party, and then I want to talk about Thanksgiving and more important things.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the Libertarian Party had a really banner year. And I'll just throw out that they also did it without encountering what would have been a strange crisis of philosophy. Essentially, if the Libertarian Party, if Gary Johnson, Bill Weld had reached 5% nationally, I believe then they would have qualified for matching federal funds to become, essentially millions of dollars to become a major political party. Luckily, they avoided that and got just under with just around 3% of the popular vote. It was over 4 million votes, so it's four times. It quadrupled Gary Johnson's popular vote amount from 2012 when you and I were volunteering for the campaign together in 2012. So they quadrupled those totals to make the highest amount the Libertarian Party has ever received on a national scale in its history. I think you can even combine 40 years of votes in it for the Libertarian Party national ticket, and it just barely squeezes over the amount that Gary Johnson got this year alone. So the Libertarian Party is very happy. Obviously, Gary Johnson is done running for office. I'm not sure what Bill Weld's plans are, but the Libertarian Party itself, they are now automatically on the ballot in 37 states out of 50. And you're aware, Roger, of the struggle for ballot access. That is no small thing. That's going to save the Libertarian Party hundreds of thousands of dollars, thousands of hours of volunteer and signature gathering work. So the Libertarian Party came out on top, and they did it without having to face that, again, that crisis of philosophy where if they got more than 5%, then would they accept millions of dollars from the federal government to fund their major political party, or would they turn it down?
It would be a nice problem to have. Yeah. You know, I like Gary Johnson. I think he's a very good guy, and he was a great governor, and he's a good friend. You know, I frankly think his messaging was crisper when he ran 4 years ago. But he worked very hard, and he had the courage to run when others didn't. Bill Weld, as I have said before, is a very shrewd guy, a friend of mine, a smart guy, and I think he was a quisling for the Clintons. He was shilling for an embassy, for an ambassadorship from the beginning. And he spent more time bashing Donald Trump than he did supporting Gary Johnson. But that said, Weld had an excellent record as governor. I disagree with him on so many issues. I'm not really sure. I think he was a libertarian in his gubernatorial years, but arguably later he becomes a Bush functionary. Not surprising, given the relationship between the Welds and the Bushes in the banking business in Massachusetts and New England. These are the Brahmins. So, Travis Irvine, great to have you back on the Stone Cold Truth. And next week, maybe we'll talk about Christmas.
Absolutely, Roger. Take care.
In the New York Times best-selling book, The Man Who Killed Kennedy, The Case Against LBJ, Roger Stone has gathered documents and uses his first-hand knowledge to construct the ultimate book to prove that LBJ was not only involved in JFK's assassination, but that he was in fact the mastermind. Find out how, and much more, in The Man Who Killed Kennedy, The Case Against LBJ. Get yours today at lbjkilledjfk.com. New York Times best-selling author Roger Stone brings you Nixon's Secrets. In Nixon's Secrets, Stone reveals how the Kennedys wiretapped Nixon's hotel room the night before the Nixon-Kennedy debate and stole Nixon's medical records from his psychiatrist's office. Stone lays out how Kennedy's running mate Lyndon Johnson stole Texas from JFK through voter fraud, while Mayor Richard Daley stole Illinois, and how JFK actually lost the popular vote. Get Nixon's Secrets today at stonecoldtruth.com.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-615-7709. That's 800-615-7709.
800-615-7709.
Winter has just begun, and are you already tired of being cold? How would you like to never be cold again? This is Dale with Fortress Clothing, and I'm here to tell you, you will never be cold again with Fortress. If you're tired of freezing your butt off, elk hunting, sitting in a tree stand, deer hunting, winter camping, fishing, ice fishing, no longer fear the cold. If you snowmobile, ski, snowboard, get Fortress. Sledding with the kids, shoveling the walks, shopping, or if you or your spouse get cold feet at home, get Fortress. If you're stuck outside working in the cold or find yourself in an emergency situation, get our winter bug out bag and you will never be cold again. Fortress is the answer, so quit complaining and go to fortressclothing.com. It's a mid-layer garment that goes with anything you want to wear. Enter coupon code radio and get 20% off any item. Go now while we still have inventory. FortressClothing.com.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson. Injury Help Desk is responsible for this advertisement. Principal Office, Las Vegas, Nevada. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention heartburn drug users. If you or a loved one has taken Nexium, Prevacid, or Prilosec to treat heartburn, acid reflux, or indigestion, and suffered serious kidney damage, chronic kidney disease, or kidney failure, you may be entitled to substantial financial compensation. Studies from the JAMA Internal Medicine indicate a significant increased risk of acute and chronic kidney disease from taking proton pump inhibitors. If you or a loved one was diagnosed with kidney failure or chronic kidney disease after taking Nexium, Prevacid, or Prilosec to treat heartburn, acid reflux, or indigestion, you may be entitled to substantial financial compensation. Act now. Time is limited to file a claim. For a free consultation and free information, call Injury Help Desk now. You may be entitled to substantial financial compensation. Call 800-225-8944. That's 800-225-8944. Again, 800-225-8944. Call now.
Welcome back to the Stone Cold Truth. We're here in the Stone Zone talking politics, and we've just passed the 53rd anniversary of the JFK assassination. Joining us now is Republican pollster John McClaughlin, who does, I think, some of the most cutting-edge, incredible survey research for Republicans and conservatives and free enterprise oriented organizations in the country. Works with his brother Jim McClaughlin. These are two of the most talented survey research analysts I know. John recently worked with the great Tony Fabrizio to help make America great, and has an intimate knowledge of the polling that charts this entire race. So, John, you see him on Fox, you hear him on the radio constantly. Welcome to the Stone Cold Truth.
Roger, great to be talking to you again. So
this is an easy place to start. I mean, John, you track this race and you know it intimately. Why did the mainstream media, why did the major pollsters get it wrong, and were the polls, as the WikiLeaks disclosures told us, to a certain extent rigged for Hillary?
Well, it was, because they wanted her to win, and they were drinking their own Kool-Aid. So they were basing their polls off models of 2012 electorate, where Barack Obama had gotten 2% turnouts of African-Americans, high turnouts of younger voters, and it done really well with Democrat core constituency. So the exit polls nationally 4 years ago were +6 Democrat model. So they were putting in +6. They were putting in ABC had a +10. So they were skewing all the polls full of Democrats. And we knew that Hillary wasn't going to quite do as well because she's not Barack Obama. And there was going to be a diminution of younger voters, and African-Americans weren't coming out as much. And she wasn't even going to do as well with Hispanics as Obama did. So Donald Trump had done a really good job of reaching out to working class voters.
and as you know him really well. He can connect. It's so ironic. Here's a guy who's a billionaire for New York City who can connect with the working class people across the country. So he built a new coalition for the Republicans of Sunbelt voters combined with Rust Belt voters, where he maxed out evangelical Christians, and then he goes and wins these working class voters who didn't even turn out 4 years ago for Mitt Romney.
Yes, which is, of course, the renewal of the Nixon-Reagan Republican coalition. We are back to that same coalition, blue-collar white Democrats in places like western Pennsylvania and suburban Michigan and many parts of Wisconsin with traditional Republican voters. It has forged a new coalition. In my opinion, to cement that coalition, now is the historic opportunity to take African-American voters who have been so habitually Democratic to make inroads there to ultimately take that constituency, which can only be done through an agenda of economic growth and empowerment, bring prosperity and opportunity to the inner cities, to black people. They're beginning to understand in greater and greater numbers that they've been taken for advantage of by the Democrats, who promised them great things, but deliver nothing when it comes down to it. In any event, were you surprised on Election Day, or did you see the trend line that a handful of people saw that appeared that he would cross the line with Hillary at almost exactly the right time?
No, we weren't surprised, and we were cautiously optimistic, though. There's some younger people in the campaign that do a lot of analytics. They were looking at the analytics that they were going to win on Tuesday. This was over the weekend. I was talking to people inside the Trump campaign, and they were showing me the analytics at the RNC, and they worked up. And I was like, you still need to win Tuesday. You still need to win the turnout on Tuesday. And we had five great pollsters working with the campaign. Tony Fabrizio, you absolutely mentioned, a fantastic, an old friend. And you had Kellyanne Conway. Her firm was polling.
Very talented, very capable. Somebody I've known for a long time.
In the last week, we had Ohio, and they stopped tracking in Ohio because we kept on showing them ahead. And Georgia had polls there, and it was one of those things where it looked really good. And the thing is, we then put Trump went to play in Michigan and Pennsylvania, and as soon as we scheduled them, Hillary was right in there behind us, which meant that their polls were showing the same thing.
Yes,
that
They saw the slippage. Right. They also, at that point, paid $2 million to Beyonce and Jay-Z for an endorsement and a concert, because they began to see their numbers in terms of just turnout eroding among African-American voters. And it was not incidental that the online videos of Danny Williams, Bill's abandoned son, got a grand total of about 70 million hits. Anyway, moving on from there, do you think that Trump can hold this coalition together?
Yes, by policies. He's got to move on the policies. Your point is, he could actually expand it. Because if his policies succeed, and I agree with you, African-American voters, they're not going to vote 95-5 anymore. Barack Obama's not running anymore. And you know, it's ironic. In midterm elections, the governor of Georgia is my client. We got 11% of the black vote. And the lieutenant governor, running against an African-American woman, got 20% because we had school choice policy, because we had policies that created jobs.
We're definitely. I mean, there's slow progress is being made there. Look, we got to go back to our birthright as the party of Lincoln. I mean, I shouldn't say we, because technically I'm still a registered member of the Libertarian Party. But who knows?
You're coming back.
I have to rejoin the party of Trump. This is the party of Trump. Yeah. Every Republican president has remade the party in his own image. Lincoln, McKinley,
right.
Theodore Roosevelt, Dwight D. Eisenhower, modern republicanism, Richard Nixon, bridging the gap between both wings of the party, Ronald Reagan taking the party to be the conservative party, and the final realignment. Try to find a conservative Democrat today. Try to find them.
Right.
It's a dwindling statistic. How did Trump end up doing among Jewish voters, John?
Jewish voters, I don't think we did as well or as high as we hoped. The ones who live in Israel who vote in the United States or Americans, we did really well with. We won that vote.
I'm sure we did. So tell me, do you remember a number? Because I haven't seen really good cross tabs. I'm curious to look at that, because I think that's an area also where we can make gains. We will now prove that we are the friends of Israel. And I think we can make gains there as well. But I think we have to be honest. We are going to have to go into the barrio as well. The answer for Trump's deficit among Hispanic voters is really the same as it is, as I discussed, for African Americans. He's got to deliver a better quality of life to Hispanic people and greater opportunity and greater opportunity for prosperity.
And he did better than Mitt Romney. He did better than Mitt Romney with Hispanics. And the other part is, it's the ones who are voting are citizens.
Yes.
And when he fixes the immigration system so that it's a fair place for everybody, where if you're in line waiting, there's a lot of Hispanics that have friends and relatives waiting in line.
Yes.
And
yes.
Other people are cutting the line illegally.
John, we're out of time, so I got to cut you off. But thank you for joining us here in the Stone Zone on Stone Cold Truth.
Thank you for the opportunity, Roger, and you're exactly right.
Pain doesn't take vacations. It never celebrates holidays. It's on the job 24/7 to keep your life exactly where it is, in limbo. But it doesn't have to be that way, because Laser Spine Institute can help you take back your life from chronic neck and back pain. With a less than 1-inch incision, our minimally invasive procedures have provided relief to over 60,000 patients with a 97% patient satisfaction rate. So get ready to stand tall and live the life you've imagined for yourself without pain. Are you or a loved one suffering from a bulging disc, herniated disc, spinal stenosis, pinched nerve, or degenerative disc disease? Call our spine care consultants now at
855-519-BACK.
For a no-cost MRI review and to learn more, it's time to say goodbye to chronic neck and back pain.
Call 855-519-BACK now to see if laser spine surgery is right for you. That's 855-519-BACK.
What have you got to lose? Laser Spine Institute, the leader in minimally invasive spine surgery.
People who can afford a LASIK procedure sure are lucky. Imagine being able to throw away your contacts and glasses. Imagine waking up tomorrow with 20/20 vision. Too bad everyone can't afford LASIK. Well, guess what? There's a company that agrees with you. TLC Laser Eye Centers is now offering great prices on high-quality LASIK to make it affordable for everyone. That means you get the latest FDA-approved all-laser LASIK technology for less than what others charge. And if you call right now, we'll schedule a free appointment so you can discover if LASIK is right for you. Results may vary. Call 1-800-933-1427. Even better, if you're one of the first 100 callers, ask about an extra $400 off your all-laser LASIK procedure. That's $200 off per eye. We've already performed over 2 million procedures. Let us help you. Discover how you can get the quality LASIK experience you deserve for less than what others charge. For your free appointment, call 1-800-933-1427. 1-800-933-1427.
How confident are you in your food storage? If it was all you had to rely on, would it sustain your family? Hard times, good times, or any time, New Mana Storable Food is the proven superior choice. Learn for yourself what happened when one man ate only New Mana Storable Food for an entire month. Online at PowerPrepper.com. That's PowerPrepper.com. Experience the New Mana difference.
America-made food stores are allowed to eat. Yum!
Will the government protect your family from Iran and North Korea's newest weapon, EMP? We buy guns to protect ourselves. Home, health, and car insurance for accidents. Maybe you also have food storage. But how would you keep your refrigerator running in a long-term EMP blackout? Using tested military designs, the Solark EMP-hardened solar generator protects and powers your critical appliances for years without burying items underground or wrapping them in aluminum foil. Unlike other preps, Solark is used every day to help offset your electric bill automatically. Visit PortableSolarLLC.com to learn how easily expandable the system is. Solark is the most affordable and powerful solution on the market. The whole system even fits in the back of a pickup or SUV and can install in less than an hour. See for yourself why Solark beats other off-grid systems at PortableSolarLLC.com. Don't wait for the government. Go to PortableSolarLLC.com to learn why Solark is energy insurance for your family.
Hi, I'm Dr. Craig Samet from Anthem. Did you know that premature birth is the number one cause of death of babies? That's why the Anthem Foundation is working with the March of Dimes to fight to end premature birth and birth defects. But you can do something today to give them tomorrow. Your support means programs, education, life-saving research, and a voice for families in the newborn intensive care unit. Together, we can help save babies' lives. Give them tomorrow at marchofdimes.org/tomorrow.
We have the hard-charging Washington bureau chief for Breitbart News. Breitbart News is the new center of the universe in the Trump age because it leads the pack in the alternative media that America is increasingly turning to. You see, the old mainstream media no longer has their monopoly, and that produces stars like Matt Boyle. Before we bring him on, I'm going to kind of talk out of school and say, even though Matt and I speak often and our conversations are generally off the record, he is one of the few people I know who saw from the beginning and even in the Trump campaign's darkest hours insisted that Trump could and would win from the beginning. So, Matt Boyle, welcome to the Stone Zone here at the Stone Cold Truth.
Roger, thanks for having me.
I am really delighted to be here because you are, like me, a friend of the great Steve Bannon, who I respect enormously as a revolutionary, as a guy who believes deeply in certain principles, yet can also think outside the box in terms of coalition building and who really has a keen understanding of the alternative media, which is very important when your campaign is outspent 9-1. I figure Soros and the boys dropped somewhere near close to $2 billion, perhaps $1.5 billion. And I think the forces, at least in the paid arena, fighting for Trump probably spent $270 million. And then what is the... what's the wall-to-wall advertising of CNN worth? But anyway, Matt.
Yeah, that's probably about right. I mean, I think it's absolutely amazing that he pulled this off. I always knew he was going to do it. I know you always knew he was going to do it. But it's so amazing seeing it happen. Trump took on three establishments, if you will, throughout the whole course of the campaign, and he took on the Republican establishment during the primaries and the general election. There were a lot of Republicans that never came around to supporting him during the general election and actually campaigned against him and tried to tank his campaign. He also took on the Democrat establishment. So he took down the Bush establishment, he took down the Clinton establishment, and then he took down the media establishment too. And you could probably throw in there too a fourth one, which is the entire institutional donor class, if you will, right? Like, and they tried to support every other option other than him, and it's remarkable seeing it happen. there's a certain mentality that it takes to defeat all of these establishments. And Trump had that from the beginning. I noticed that in him. There were some other anti-establishment type candidates early in the primaries that I thought had a chance, but it was Trump that had this, I'm going to win no matter what mentality.
Put his head down and drove it through. I totally agree. He's a bulldog. There's no question. When he sets his mind to something, he is single-minded. I do think it's important to recognize the role that Breitbart News played in this. You were out there early with incisive reporting, and the hysteria with which the media has attacked Steve Bannon, the smears against him, the name-calling, I view all of this as a testimony to his effectiveness, and I have said it, on many programs and in many forums. Steve sees the big picture. That's why they would like to co-opt him. I mean, Reince Priebus would not have been my choice. I'm going to give the president the benefit of the doubt, and if Reince is loyal to the Trump agenda, I will have no problems. But beyond that, I think Trump must remain loyal to Trumpism. That means seal the borders. That means renegotiate the trade deals. That means revitalize our economy, cut taxes and restrictions and regulation, and get us a coherent foreign policy that isn't war, that isn't immediately, well, let's go to war. Because the Clinton-Obama policies have brought us to the brink of war with Russia. And war over Syria is insanity, in my opinion.
Yeah, I agree with all of that. And I think that the other thing he has to do is, in revitalizing the American economy, is we have to make things in America again. We have to really revitalize our American manufacturing sector. That's the heart. And the beating heart of America's economy, and that's what separates us from the rest of the world, and that's why you're seeing our competitors on the world stage, whether they be Mexico or China or elsewhere throughout Asia and Latin America, are trying to drain that part of our economy out, and that's one of the things that I think Donald Trump understands as a real estate guy, is he understands we can't become a service economy. If we become a service economy, we're in trouble. But your point about the media is also extraordinarily important. I think over the course of this election, one of, if not the biggest stories, is that the legacy establishment media are no longer the mainstream media. Breitbart News, I would like to declare here and now for that Breitbart News has supplanted the New York Times as the news outlet of record in America. And we are now collectively, as the alternative right-wing media, the new media, we are, and there's elements of this on the left as well, by the way. It's not just
yes,
right.
No, you're the, you're the,
we are,
you're
we the, are the mainstream media.
No, you are the new gray lady. They are the fringe now, unfortunately. We are the mainstream. We're the new mainstream.
That's exactly correct.
Because people
and the reason
can, this
why is because we went out there and we did reporting. We went and listened to the people in Pennsylvania, and we listened to the people in Michigan, and we listened to the people in Ohio and Wisconsin, and we heard their concerns, and we reported on them. The rest of the media was trying to cover this up. They weren't doing journalism.
In fact, here, that's exactly the point, which is the role of journalism in Watergate is interesting because Nixon fashions a very tight cover-up, and the New York Times, the Washington Post, and then the New York Times as well. Ultimately, even though he wins a resounding victory, their reporting undercovers a whole panoply of abuses that removes him from power. In this election, the Washington Post and the New York Times played the exact opposite role. They were dedicated to covering up groundbreaking stories about Hillary Clinton and the corruption of the Clinton Foundation and various other scandals, almost too numerous to mention, at the same time trying to do a full Barry Goldwater on Donald Trump. He's insane. He's mentally unbalanced. He's a sexist. He's a racist. He's a bigot. He's an anti-Semite, none of which is true. The full Goldwater. So I agree, and I heartily endorse your declaration that the Breitbart News is the new New York Times. Look, the New York Times is owned by Carlos Slim, at least a controlling interest, the Mexican billionaire, who ironically is the number one single largest donor to the Clinton Foundation. So,
I hope the Trump administration moves forward with their plans. I know that they talked about this during the campaign. The campaign talked about how they were going to crack down on foreign ownership of U.S. media outlets, as well as the oligopolies that we're seeing throughout the media with these major conglomerates and mergers. And by the way,
I should say because I think it's a key point that when I criticize the New York Times. Broadly, that's probably unfair. I think there are some fine reporters there doing fine reporting. I see stories that I think are incisive and accurate all the time. But then I see things that they write that are so egregious in their wrongness. There's a front page quote that I saw the morning after the election. Donald Trump won his victory while disparaging, I think it was, I'm paraphrasing, disparaging minorities, women, gays, and Hispanics. No, he didn't.
Yeah, and no, he didn't. Roger, I think you're exactly right about there being good people throughout the media, and I want to extend a hand to, if there are good reporters, and I know there are throughout the rest of the media, they are more than welcome to come to Breitbart. Breitbart can be their new safe place to do journalism. We are hiring here. I'm in talks with people at the New York Times and at the Washington Post and throughout the rest of the media. They are more than welcome to come here and do journalism here rather than continue this cover-up mentality that they're being told to do. And we're more than open to hiring them here at Breitbart.
Well, there you go. Job opportunity from Stone Zone. There you go. Thank you, Matt Boyle, Breitbart Washington Bureau Chief, for dropping in here at the Stone Cold Truth.
Absolutely. Anytime.
New York Times best-selling author Roger Stone brings you Nixon's Secrets. In Nixon's Secrets, Stone reveals how the Kennedys wiretapped Nixon's hotel room the night before the Nixon-Kennedy debate and stole Nixon's medical records from his psychiatrist's office. Stone lays out how Kennedy's running mate, Lyndon Johnson, stole Texas from JFK through voter fraud, while Mayor Richard Daley stole Illinois, and how JFK actually lost the popular vote. Get Nixon's Secrets today at stonecoldtruth.com. Roger Stone, New York Times best-selling author, brings you Nixon's Secrets. Nixon's Secrets shows how Hillary Clinton was fired from the 1974 Nixon Impeachment Committee staff for lying and violating Nixon's rights, and how Hillary tried unsuccessfully to block Nixon from the Clinton White House. No wonder Nixon, upon meeting Hillary for the first time, said, "She's cold, cold as ice." Find out more at stonecoldtruth.com.
From the pages of the Bible comes a terrifying account of an ancient beast that was half man, half demon. It is returned in a best-selling novel, Nephilim, by L.A. Marzulli. Indiegogo presents you with an opportunity to get involved in making this supernatural novel into a major motion picture. Join journalist Mac McKenzie as he travels halfway around the world to uncover the truth about aliens and demons. Join our Indiegogo campaign to get Nephilim made into a movie. Go to Indiegogo.com/Nephilim.
Did you know your car can be hacked just like your computer or phone? Hackers can hijack the signal of your own key fob to burglarize your vehicle in seconds. The Black Hole Faraday Key Fob Bag is a signal impenetrable shield that stops these hacks in their tracks. Protect one of your most valuable assets. Go to hackproofbag.com. That's hackproofbag.com and use promo code radio to get 20% off. Or call 805-222-4584. 805-222-4584.
This program is brought to you by the Genesis Communications Network, a world leader in talk radio since 1998. Visit GCNLive.com today.
Welcome back. The Stone Cold Truth here on the Genesis Communications Network. We're proud to be where you can find our good friend Alex Jones and so many more great talkers. Here we are celebrating in many quarters here in South Florida among the Cuban-American community the death of El Jefe, the heavy-handed dictator Fidel Castro. Senator Marco Rubio recently, just moments ago, said it so eloquently, which is the death of Castro does not mean change in Cuba. His brother is as dogmatic and as doctrinaire, perhaps even more vicious than Fidel, and he remains, even in his doddering years, in control. There is no freedom of the press. There is no freedom of religion. There is no freedom of expression. There is no freedom of association. There is no freedom of communications. It is a gulag. It is not the socialist utopia that some dingbats on the left and other mainstream media types would like it to be. Fidel Castro is not a romantic figure, not a Robin Hood, not for the people. He is a mass murderer. He is a thug, as was his ally Che Guevara. I have a friend who lives in Little Havana who told me over a beer that anytime he sees somebody wearing a Che Guevara t-shirt, he has an overwhelming compunction to punch them out. And of course, I cautioned him against violence. People don't understand the extent to which Castro has dominated American politics and foreign policy since he rose. The dictator Batista, who he replaced, believe me, was no day at the beach when it came to corruption or human rights violations. He too was a thug, and that created the atmosphere in which a rebel like Castro could seize a control. Castro's own deep understanding of myth-making and image-making is profound. He comes to the United States, to the UN, the Cuban UN mission. He checks into a very ritzy New York hotel. He sends out and has chickens brought in that have been recently slaughtered, and he unplucks them and cooks them in his hotel room. And the New York press goes wild for the bearded ones. It is interesting that Ed Cox, who is Richard Nixon's son-in-law, met with Castro. The relevance of that in a moment. It is important to note that the Eisenhower administration didn't really quite early know what to make of Castro, and Vice President Richard Nixon was assigned to meet with him. Meeting with Eisenhower would have connoted recognition by the state, and we weren't sure if we wanted to do that. So Nixon met privately with Castro. You can see the photos. If you go to Google Images right now, put in Nixon Castro of them smiling and standing next to each other. Nixon came away from the meeting and wrote Eisenhower a famous memo saying, "This guy's posing as a Democrat, small d, but he's a communist, and he is aligned with the Soviets, and Cuba will become a Soviet satellite state if he is allowed to stay in power." This caused what was known in intelligence circles as Operation 40. Operation 40 was a secret government-sanctioned operation to meld the CIA and the mob, organized crime, in a series of plots to assassinate Castro. And the man who gave the green light, the man who headed the task force on Operation 40, was none other than Vice President Richard Nixon. Ike did not want to get his hands dirty with what he knew needed to be done. Specifically, an FBI agent who had worked for Howard Hughes, was authorized to reach out to Johnny Roselli of organized crime fame. Roselli was a playboy gunman and cutthroat. And the purpose of the alliance was simple. Castro had expelled all of the CIA assets on the island, but because of the mob-owned hotel casinos, the island was still riddled with low-level mobsters who could be informants about Castro's movements, Castro's habits, Castro's daily routine. And indeed, yes, we did really try an exploding cigar. There were numerous attempts on Castro's life, and he knew it. Ultimately, Operation 40 failed and morphed into the Bay of Pigs operation. The Bay of Pigs was supposed to be a two-tiered operation where we would not only have Cuban rebels storm the beaches at the Bay of Pigs, but Castro would be simultaneously assassinated and control of the island's radio network would be seized. It was, from the beginning, a fiasco. The conditions that Kennedy gave the Central Intelligence Agency regarding this operation was that it had to look like a Cuban uprising and that the United States government needed deniability. At the end, the failed mission on the beaches, where Castro clearly had prior knowledge of our invasion and our allies were being cut to ribbons by sniper fire, the Pentagon and the Central Intelligence Agency wanted JFK to order airstrikes, and he refused. And there are the seeds of one element of his ultimate assassination. So the Bay of Pigs is a fiasco. It is not coincidental that several of the Watergate burglars, several of the veterans of Operation 40 are also veterans of the Bay of Pigs invasion, are also veterans actually on the ground in Dealey Plaza when Kennedy is assassinated, and show up as Watergate burglars. How likely is that? I think it charts the related nature of all these cataclysmic events in our American history. And Castro has bedeviled American foreign policy. Now, there are those who say, well, Kennedy was killed by the Russians and Castro. Actually, even after the attempts to assassinate him under Kennedy, John Kennedy had reached out to Castro through a French journalist who was a friend of Jacqueline Kennedy, and also through an ambassador he had gone to Princeton with who was a boyhood friend, and given Castro the word that he wanted to talk. So Castro had no motive. Castro was surprised, but he agreed. Lyndon Johnson would later say, well, Jack was killed because we were running a damn murder incorporated down there in the Caribbean. This was an effort to deflect from the fact that the Kennedy assassination was not done by Fidel Castro, not done by the Russians, but that is the cover story of those who are confronted with the stark reality that the Warren Commission has fallen apart, and therefore there has to be a conspiracy. Now we're told it's a conspiracy of the communists. It is odd that while everybody in Dallas believes that John Kennedy has been killed by a right-winger, Malcolm Kilduff, JFK's deputy press secretary, asks Vice President, now President Johnson, and he says, well, son, we don't know what kind of a communist conspiracy killed Jack. The great Carnac? How did he know it was a communist? Because Oswald was a patsy. Welcome. Great to have you here, rocking along on the Stone Cold Truth. Coming up, Gerald Posner exposes the U.S.-Saudi connection.
Don't know what contaminants are lurking in your water? Time to get a ProPure. Take advantage of ProPure's holiday sale. Save 25% on all ProPure water filter products. Sales good through December 31st. There's a ProPure water filter for you. Visit your authorized ProPure dealer for details or ProPureUSA.com. That's ProPureUSA.com.
Roger Stone, New York Times best-selling author, brings you Nixon's Secrets. Nixon's Secrets shows how Hillary Clinton was fired from the 1974 Nixon Impeachment Committee staff for lying and violating Nixon's rights, and how Hillary tried unsuccessfully to block Nixon from the Clinton White House. No wonder Nixon, upon meeting Hillary for the first time, said, "She's cold. Cold as ice." Find out more at stonecoldtruth.com. In the New York Times best-selling book, The Man Who Killed Kennedy, The Case Against LBJ, Roger Stone has gathered documents and uses his first-hand knowledge to construct the ultimate book to prove that LBJ was not only involved in JFK's assassination, but he was in fact the mastermind. Find out how, and much more, in The Man Who Killed Kennedy, The Case Against LBJ. Get yours today at lbjkilledjfk.com.
Did you know your car can be hacked just like your computer or phone? Hackers can hijack the signal of your own key fob to burglarize your vehicle in seconds. The Black Hole Faraday Key Fob Bag is a signal impenetrable shield that stops these hacks in their tracks. Protect one of your most valuable assets. Go to hackproofbag.com. That's hackproofbag.com. And use promo code RADIO to get 20% off. Or call 805-222-4584. 805-222-4584.
You know about RVs, you've heard about bunkers, but surviving is not recreation, and man wasn't made to live underground. Introducing Survivalist Camps, the ultimate fully functional off-the-grid survival bug-out house that's mobile, well-equipped, and custom-built to outlast any other RV or trailer. Go to survivalistcamps.com to learn more. That's survivalistcamps.com, providing your basic needs to survive. Survivalistcamps.com.
Dangerous blood clot device alert. If you or a loved one had an IVC filter placed to prevent blood clots from traveling to your heart or lungs and suffered an injury, you may be entitled to substantial financial compensation. The FDA warns that IVC filters may cause serious complications, such as heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, and even death. These dangerous blood clot devices can break, and the metal fragments can travel to your heart or lungs, causing serious injuries. If you or a loved one suffered organ damage or other injuries from an IVC filter, you may be entitled to substantial financial compensation. Act now. Time is limited to file a claim. For a free consultation and free information, call Injury Help Desk at 800-478-1507. 800-478-1507. 800-478-1507.
This is an advertisement. Paid non-attorney spokesperson. InjuryHelpDesk.com is responsible for this advertisement. Principal office, Las Vegas, Nevada.
This is Ben Gordon, and if your teeth are stained from coffee, tea, or smoking, Power Swabs is the answer. In 5 minutes, you'll see 2 shades whiter teeth, and in 7 days, 6 shades. There's no messy strips or trays that you have to leave in your mouth for an hour. Just swab your teeth for 5 minutes, and you're done. To try Power Swabs, call 1-800-290-8480. Your bright white smile will have your friends talking about how great you look. Try it risk-free. 1-800-290-8480. That's 1-800-290-8480.
You have tuned in to the Stone Cold Truth here on the Genesis Communications Network. We are honored to have a gentleman that I squared off with only this past week, because on the 53rd anniversary of the Kennedy assassination, I debated Gerald Posner, the New York Times best-selling author of Case Closed, perhaps the most comprehensive argument for the fact that Lee Harvey Oswald was the murderer of John Kennedy and that he acted alone, which I, of course, disagree with. And we debated this at Books and Books. Glenn Garvin of the Miami Herald graciously moderated. We had a great audience. We had a huge crowd on Facebook Live and on Periscope and on the Stone Cold Truth. Ultimately, we had a few technical problems. We had a nice hit on YouTube Live, and we had great fun. But today, I wanted to bring Gerald in because I think as President-elect Trump begins to examine his responsibilities and challenges, his relationship with the Saudis is going to need some reworking. I mean, the Saudis are currently fighting the legislation that holds them legally responsible for the death of Americans in 9/11. There's a whole group of American citizens who want to sue over the Saudis, which would be allowed under this legislation. So they're still pulling strings. And Gerald Posner has written two of what I consider the definitive works on the broader subject of not only our complicated relationship with the Saudis, who pretend to be our friend while feeding Wahhabism. This is the old, if I feed the alligator may eat me last philosophy. And 9/11, which is still, in my view, broadly unexplored. So, Gerald Posner, welcome back to Into the Stone Zone here at the Stone Cold Truth.
Roger, great to be with you. And, you know, you're a New York Times bestselling author. Your book on LBJ being behind the Kennedy assassination has been there. You know how tough it is to get on that list. I've done 12 books. Three have made it. My last one on the Vatican, God's Bankers. But the book that actually did the best on the Times was the book Why America Slept. It came out in 2003. That was not something the government wanted to hear, not something the CIA wanted to hear, because I disclose in there the fact that I think we got from an al-Qaeda suspect who's still down in Guantanamo, sort of the Rosetta Stone to 9/11 and how the Saudis were involved in a confession from him. And then the CIA's done everything it can since then to destroy the evidence and bury the truth, and the government hasn't pursued it. That book got to number two, by the way, on the Times list. To my eternal shame, the person that kept me off being a New York Times number one bestseller was Al Franken, of all people.
Good God. So, you know, that guy, he wasn't even funny when he was a comedian, and he's less funny now in terrible. The U.S. Senate.
So the joke was, terrible. I could never believe that. But there's something, you know, it's an unusual state. I don't want to insult everybody from Minnesota, but they have some unusual choices, and Frank concerning one of them. But I must tell you that I think that one of the things that President-elect Trump will face maybe down the road, he's got a lot of other priorities, clearly, that are going to be on top of this. But, you know, you talk about the Saudis and that. And you said, quite correctly, the unexplained questions around 9/11, I have them, and I know where there's evidence of cover-ups and that, and I wonder if President-elect Trump at some point in his first 4 years will appoint a commission to be the real commission or that, or the real investigative group, past the 9/11 commission that issued that report, because that report was a whitewash. And that's why I wrote my second book about Secrets of the Kingdoms. They didn't address the key issues in there. And we now know that the CIA not only destroyed videotapes of interrogations of al-Qaeda prisoners, they admitted that in 2007 that they had done that, but they didn't provide the key videotapes that I think could be smoking guns to the 9/11 commission. So that commission did its work without the evidence it needed.
Yeah, it's similar to the x-rays and the photos not going to the Warren Commission. In any event,
I mean, you know, you and me, we reach a different conclusion on what happened in Kennedy, and that's fair enough, but there's no question that the Warren Commission it didn't have the right evidence before, it didn't pursue the right grounds, and didn't go after the mob connections, as you say, with Jack Ruby, all those things. No wonder no one believed it when they came out with their conclusions. And the 9/11 Commission came out with a report that's just sort of said, okay, 19 hijackers, you know, four planes, that's it, and no foreign connections. And I'll tell you, to say that in light of the financing and what we now know from this interrogation in this prisoner in Guantanamo about three Saudi princes, and the head of Pakistan's Air Force. He gave the secret cell phone numbers and contact information to his interrogators because they did a fake flag operation in which he believed he was being held by the Saudis, not by Americans. And then after we get that information and we tell our so-called allies, the Saudis and Pakistanis, Roger, what happens to those four people? One of them was the nephew of the king and the owner of the biggest media empire in Saudi Arabia. They all die. One of them, the 43-year-old prince, dies of either a heart attack or a blood clot, depending on which medical report you believe, after a liposuction operation in a Riyadh hospital. The second prince dies the next day on his way to the funeral of the first prince. The third prince dies a week later. This is my personal favorite. In his Rolls Royce, 55 miles outside of the capital of Saudi Arabia, the royal court says he dies of, quote, of thirst. I'm not kidding you. He forgot to bring along a bottle of Perrier or Evian when he went in the desert. And the fourth guy, the head of Pakistan's Air Force, an air marshal, dies when his airplane blows up with his wife, family, and his top aides aboard. And Pakistan, 10 years later, still hasn't found out who's responsible for that. So all four guys given to us by this al-Qaeda terrorist who's down in Guantanamo, Abu Zubaydah, he's one of those still there. All four end up dead. And the American intelligence, all of them, NSA, CIA, the Defense Intelligence, run for cover and say the account in my book is wrong, it's not true, and meanwhile they're destroying tapes. So, you know, something doesn't smell right in the state of Denmark here.
Well, look, perhaps President Trump should appoint you to head a new commission to look into, I mean, you're an attorney, you're an accomplished attorney, you're a silver-tongued advocate for your point of view. I must say, it took me a while because I was trying to make America great, but I worked my way through your entire book on the Vatican, and it was superb. So I highly recommend it. Tell us the name again so I can...
God's Bankers is the book.
Yes.
You think that Goldman Sachs or the J.P. Morgan or Wells Fargo, they're doing nefarious things and fooling around with people's money. Madoff's been a terrible scam. Yeah, there's terrible things happening with the big banks in Wall Street, no doubt. But, boy, I'm a Catholic, and I will tell you that the guys who run the church do a good job running the church. But when it comes to money, they make all the scandals on Wall Street look like child's play. And Roger, I like your idea of a suggestion of a commission. I'm not the right guy to head it, but I think I could be a good counsel to the commission.
Just like Arlen Specter. So,
no,
thank you, Gerald. Thanks. Thanks for coming to the Stone Zone.
In the New York Times best-selling book, The Man Who Killed Kennedy, The Case Against LBJ, Roger Stone has gathered documents and uses his first-hand knowledge to construct the ultimate book to prove that LBJ was not only involved in JFK's assassination, but that he was in fact the mastermind. Find out how, and much more, in The Man Who Killed Kennedy, The Case Against LBJ. Get yours today at lbjkilledjfk.com. New York Times best-selling author Roger Stone brings you Nixon's Secrets. In Nixon's Secrets, Stone reveals how the Kennedys wiretapped Nixon's hotel room the night before the Nixon-Kennedy debate and stole Nixon's medical records from his psychiatrist's office. Stone lays out how Kennedy's running mate Lyndon Johnson stole Texas from JFK through voter fraud, while Mayor Richard Daley stole Illinois, and how JFK actually lost the popular vote. Get Nixon's Secrets today at stonecoldtruth.com.
Are you feeling embarrassed or stuck because you can't focus or concentrate? I have a confession to make. I spent years unable to think clearly, like I was in a fog. I was going through the motions, running my companies, and I hated feeling mentally sluggish. I couldn't get ahead like this. It's no secret. The powers that be want us dumbed down. Chemicals, fluoride, our brains are under siege, and we are experiencing lower IQs. But now there is a weapon to fight back and win. Introducing DNA Evolve, a revolutionary breakthrough in the category of cognitive enhancers called nootropics. I've been using DNA Evolve and couldn't feel better. For me, it works. It feels great to get things done again and get ahead. Try a free sample for yourself at DNAEvolveSample.com. That's DNAEvolveSample.com. Supplies are limited, so go to DNAEvolveSample.com right now.
for P150, P150GA, P150NY, P150OK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states. If New York or Colorado, call for a similar offer.
What's the scariest thing about going to the dentist? Opening your mouth or opening your wallet? Because just a simple cleaning can cost $100, and things like root canals can cost you hundreds more. If you don't have dental insurance to help, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company, 1-800-656-4939. This isn't a discount plan or preventive-only coverage. This is real dental insurance that helps pay for checkups right away. So you can call today and get your teeth cleaned tomorrow. Plus, it helps cover the more expensive procedures you might need down the road. Fillings, crowns, bridges, even costly dentures. There's no deductible and no annual maximum. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. There are no networks, so you can choose any dentist you'd like. Call now for a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-656-4939. That's 1-800-656-4939. 1-800-656-4939.
Hello, I'm Mike Lindell, the inventor of MyPillow. And like all of you out there, I had problems sleeping. Pillows would go flat. I would flip-flop all night long. I would wake up with a sore neck, maybe a headache, or feel like I needed a nap even though I slept 8 hours. When I invented MyPillow, I wanted it to where you can move the patented fill to give you the exact support you need as an individual, regardless of sleep position. MyPillow will get you into that deep REM sleep faster, and you will stay there longer. It's not about how much time we spend in bed. It's about how much of that quality sleep we get. I do all of my own manufacturing right here in the United States. I have a 10-year warranty. You can wash and dry my pillow, and I give you a 60-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. And here's my best offer ever. You can buy one of my pillows and get one absolutely free.
Go to MyPillow.com or call 800-870-0305 and use promo code GCN. That's MyPillow.com or 800-870-0305 with promo code GCN.
We're back here at Stone Cold Truth, and now an artist joins us who I saw at the end of the campaign on Newsmax television with the great Steve Malzberg, and I saw this artist's video, music video, and it was political in nature. It was pro-Trump and political correctness, and I learned that this video was produced by Kate Koptenko, who is 16 years old, who is an emigre to the United States, who is one of the most ardent and articulate Trump supporters I have ever met, who is an incredible organizer. She writes, records, and edits her own music and her own videos, and her work is breathtaking. So welcome to the Stone Cold Truth, Kate Koptenko.
It's great to be here. Thank you.
So tell us when you came here and a little bit about your background, because I think it's part of the American experience.
Sure. Well, I was 10 years old when I came here. I learned English while living here. And
and where did you come from?
I was born in Moscow, Russia. Mm-hmm. So, yes, I came here when I was 10. I went to school and eventually got into politics.
Clearly. Well, you bring these incredible artistic skills with you, so I'm prepared to predict that you're going to have a long and successful career. I'm not sure whether it'll be as a recording artist or as a political operative, but I was Kate organized a series of rallies for Donald Trump across South Florida, and I agreed to speak at them. I was pretty much her headliner, and I was able to proselytize for Trump among hundreds of people in the campaign. It was one of the greatest grassroots experiences that I have had. Let's roll this pot boiling song. I'll let you introduce it. We have it queued up, and folks can see what I mean.
Sure. Well, the song's name is Political Correctness, and it was written in support of Donald Trump.
Thank you.
And so we return and fight. All we ever hear is the same old talk. Empty promises about change, filled with lies and the fraud. Who's gonna tell the real story without a fiction, with glory? There's not a day to spend. Let's make America great again. It's time to act, back on the track. The stakes are high till they deny. It's the fact, it never stops. Enough with fake perfectness, political correctness. Political correctness. Show me how to comfort those people who lost their money, home, and their trust. They're caught up in the absurd. Veterans who have placed their whole lives on the line are now home. Corruption's taking over everything soldiers fought for. There's not a moment to spend. Let's make America great again. It's time to act, back on that track. The stakes are high, still they deny. Here is the fact, it never stops. Enough with fake perfectness, political correctness. Give us something real, give us something true. Don't let it reach the end. Let's make America great again. It's time to act, back on that track. The stakes are high until they deny. There is the dark, it never stops. Enough with fake perfectness.
There you have it, Kate Koptenko. Wow, I am blown away. Now that guitar lick—that wasn't you, was it? Was that? Or you also play the guitar?
Well, I do play the guitar, but in the recording, no, it wasn't me.
he did a very nice job. He really knew how to bend a note. So, what's next for you? I know that you are very dedicated to the Trump revolution and. You told me on Election Day that you realized that with Soros and the globalists, while they may be in retreat, they have no intention of stopping their struggle to destroy our way of living. And these phony demonstrations that are agitprop paid for by Soros and other thugs to try to destabilize the Trump administration and to falsely claim that he is... going to cancel gay marriages, and he is going to use federal funds to build a museum for the Ku Klux Klan. That's my favorite. And that he is going to begin deporting people willy-nilly without any due process. These are all lies. We have the right man at the right time. He has to be, in my opinion, worried about the Mitt Romneys. I saw this great meme you built that said never Romney. Don't you think Romney would be an enormous mistake?
Oh, I certainly agree with you about that. I think he definitely needs to choose someone good for the Secretary of State, and I believe he's going to make the right choice.
Well, particularly when it comes to Russia, because Romney is far more bellicose and hostile against Russia than Trump. Trump favors a period of detente. Romney is among the neocons who favor war. This is the challenge I think we face. We came to the brink of nuclear war, or war over Syria. But if you say that, if you criticize that, they say you're a Russian agent. So, Kate, I'm just warning you, if you hang out with me, they're going to insist that we were Russian intelligence, that we are on the pad of the Russians. Jerry Nadler, that fool Cummings in Congress, they will say we work for the Ruskies. So stick here on the Stone Zone. We're going to have play some more of your music next week. I am so blown away by your work. Freedom fighter, activist, artist, all-around good person, Kate Koptenko. Great, right here in the Stone Zone.
For 5 years, you've been hearing about the Berkey guy, so you may know a few things about him. For example, you are well aware of the superior quality and effectiveness of Berkey water filters and accessories. But did you know the Berkeys have had independent lab tests done to prove just how effective they are? It's true, and he can email you the test results. Just visit GoBerkey.com. You may also know that the Berkey guy has helped tens of thousands of people get better prepared. Now here's something you may not know. GoBerkey.com has amazing specials and deals all the time on a wide variety of survival and preparedness products, most ready to ship same day. Visit the Berkey guy at GoBerkey.com and be sure to click the red Products on Sale Now button. You can always call toll-free 877-886-3653. Again, that's 877-886-3653. GoBerkey.com, home of the Berkey guy.
All right, guys, we're ready for our four-season sunroom, and Daddy's gonna get a rec room with refreshments.
Oh, no, we'll be sleeping under the stars.
Mom, what about the one with, you know, the fun?
Nice try, little bro. It's a gym. My gym.
Hey, Grandma's getting her Four Seasons garden room. Weather tight and still like being outdoors.
Maybe a living room. Oh, no, wait, a family hub.
Yeah!
No matter what the budget, the season, or the climate, Four Seasons Sunrooms let you and your family enjoy the outdoors inside. Call now to hear more about these great offers from the premier manufacturer of sunrooms since 1975.
More reasons for four seasons now.
To find out more, call toll-free 800-848-6333. That's 800-848-6333.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Dr. Joe Wallach is not your typical doctor. Both a veterinarian and naturopathic physician, Dr. Wallach asked, why does America spend more money on health care by far and yet ranks 50th in health and longevity worldwide? The doctor believes that people should be empowered with a basic understanding of nutrition, then take charge of their life to attain optimal health and longevity through nutrition, not by toxic prescription drugs that lead to side effects, requiring more toxic prescription drugs. Talk about being dependent on drug companies, to our own destruction no less. This is clearly a deadly recipe. Doc Wallach's message is resonating with an increasing number of Americans who are waking up to all the government and big pharma manipulation of our health care system. I like what Doc Wallach is saying and doing to enlighten people and have joined forces to help this tireless crusader spread his message. Visit GCNminerals.com and listen to Dr. Wallach's Deadly Recipes lecture. It makes a lot of sense, and I invite you to join the GCN Minerals team. Go to GCNminerals.com. That's GCNminerals.com.
As a doctor, I see patients every day who are losing their vision to age-related macular degeneration, also known as AMD. If you have blurry vision or blind spots, they can be symptoms of AMD, and if untreated, could lead to blindness. The good news? AMD can be managed with effective clinically approved treatments that may reverse some vision loss. For free AMD information, contact the Foundation Fighting Blindness at 1-800-BLINDNESS. That's 1-800-BLINDNESS. There is a cure in sight.
And we're back on the Stone Cold Truth. Join me now is someone who was way out front in the Trump revolution. Before we get to him, let me mention that for those of you who are interested in the inauguration, and I am being overwhelmed by friends and associates and Trump supporters who want to be invited, and many interested in about the counter-protest in support of the new president that I am organizing in conjunction with Alex Jones and many Tea Party groups, Citizens for Trump, and others. You can go to defendtrump.com. If you submit your information, we are going to transmit everything to appropriate officials at the official inauguration committee. We want to make sure the grassroots supporters of Trump are invited. Now, to be clear, you will get, in most cases, a very nice, a formal and ceremonial invitation suitable for framing, and then you will have the opportunity to purchase tickets to a number of public events. And those go to defray the costs of the event, so the taxpayers don't have to subsidize the inauguration. The actual swearing in is, of course, controlled by the U.S. government, controlled by the Congress of the United States, and we have no particular direct control over those tickets, but Donald J. Trump and his official team do. So, but I am happy to submit to the inaugural committee anybody who wishes to attend and was a supporter and can, of course, expect to go through the magnometers and probably be at a bar that is 10 deep and hard to get a drink. But that's the inaugural. I went to Reagan's and Nixon's inaugurals, and they were a gas. So, also, to go to Rick Grenell. Rick Grenell is a diplomat, a Republican, an activist, a commentator, someone whose work I have admired. He was a spokesman for the United States at the United Nations, and there was some discussion that he would go to the UN as an ambassador in this administration. I strongly endorsed that notion. Rick is an enormously able guy. And I'm still hopeful that you will join the administration in some other post, Rick.
Well, thanks for having me. It's good to be here. Well, I guess time will tell, and only God knows.
Well, look, I think that you not only bring a breadth of experience, but also diversity and a great sense of common sense to this administration. How do you think the choices that we have seen so far? What's your impression?
Well, look, one of the reasons I signed up with Trump early on is because I don't live in Washington, D.C. I see what's been happening in D.C. in terms of political maneuvering and back-scratching and lobbyists and people who, you know, get jobs because they are well-connected and not because they're the most experienced. So what I am so excited about with Donald Trump and his picks is that Donald Trump is somebody who's going to look at, you know, who is the best person and hire them for the job. He's got a plethora of people to abundance of riches when it comes to Secretary of State and Secretary of the Treasury. I don't know how he does it because, you know, there are multiple people that are qualified, and trying to figure out who the one person is that gets that job, I think, is pretty intense. But I'm looking forward to having a team there that wants to drain the swamp. I think the State Department needs massive reform. We can't just tinker with it. It really needs massive reform. And hopefully, you know, he's going to appoint a team of people that will go in and really shake it to its cores and try to get it back to its fundamental roots and the mission of the State Department, which is defending the United States.
Well, you know, now I think about it, and I know your great experience at the UN as a spokesman, I'd like to see you at the podium. In all honesty, you'd be terrific at that job. There's talk that Laura Ingraham...
I wouldn't take the State Department spokesman job.
No, I mean spokesman for the President of the United States at the podium.
Oh.
That's the job for you.
I thought you were talking about the State Department job. I feel like I've already done that job.
Yeah, I don't know.
That's an enormous job, though, and I think we've got great talent. I've been contacted by a lot of people who want that State Department spokesman job, and I think there are several candidates that would be fantastic. And, as you know, Roger, it's a heavy job in that it's, 24 hours a day. You have different time zones around the world who are bugging you for some sort of reaction to what the State Department or what the U.S. government thinks of something. But in terms of the White House job, I think there's also a plethora of people who would be great at that job. And that's another one of those full-time, 24/7 jobs.
I think it's grueling,
to have a relationship with Donald Trump. And I don't know him that well. So it's probably something that I would not be the best for, just simply because I think you've got to know the principal pretty well. You got to have a good chemistry, and you got to know where they're going. If you're going to speak for a politician, you better really kind of know their heart.
Yes. Well, look, I the names I have heard, Laura Ingraham, friend of mine, enormously talented lady,
yes,
would bring a serious policy talent or knowledge with it. At the same time, Monica Crowley, another name that I saw yesterday, who I know from our mutual time working for Richard Nixon, an enormously able woman, very articulate, early Trump supporter in her heart, and a Trump defender on Fox. She would be excellent. I think you would be excellent just because of the skills. It's a skill set that, it's a very difficult job, as you know, and it has eaten people alive. Obama,
yeah,
I think, went through several spokesmen.
One of the issues for the modern press secretary to understand is that daily briefing has become a big circus and a big show. And much of it is just for clips on television. But, gone is the day where we're actually getting, valuable information from the daily White House briefing. I think that the daily information is coming from other sources and other times. So, if you have a good press secretary who can get information out regularly outside of the podium, I think that's going to be the best. But we also need somebody at the podium who understands the game and can redefine issues the way that reporters are trying to define issues. You can't really take the premise of what the reporter is saying, and you have to do it with humor and firmness and a sense of confidence. So the modern press secretary, I think, is much different than the press secretaries even of the last, 10 years.
All right, Rick Grenell, we're out of time. Thank you very much for your keen insight, a man of great wisdom and experience here on the Stone Zone. We're going to go very quickly to a representative for the Tax Revolution Institute who joins us now.
Hey, good afternoon, Roger. How are you?
I am delighted to have you with us. You want to audit the IRS. We have a little bit of time here. I want you to tell people what you're up to and how they can get involved. We tried to have you last week, and I'm delighted. So tell people, your position, your mission, and so on.
fantastic. You know, and I appreciate you having me on, of course, and it's always great to stop by. You know, for those, my name is Bobby Rodrigo. I'm the legal and or operations director of Tax Revolution Institute. We are a nonprofit, 501c3. And one of our projects, advocacy positions, are transparency for the IRS. So if you go to auditirs.com, you can see that what our approach is that, you know, since the IRS certainly can audit us as citizens of the country, you know, up to 6 years minimum, without any kind of due process involved on the front end, there's our position that that needs to happen as well. You know, statutorily, for example, there's supposed to be an oversight committee that has actually never been funded or completed, at the present is not funded or even manned properly, where, so we are essentially telling Americans that we're taking that position.
Great.
So we want to audit them, that's what their behavior is. And
all right. That was very good. So, folks, go to auditirs.com, and we can join that revolution. They can audit me. I'd like to audit them. I want to remind everybody to go to stonecoldtruth.com. We've got the enormous collection of vintage Trump gear that you may like and other products, your iconic Bill Clinton Rick T-shirt. These will be in the Smithsonian. But join us next week at the Stone Cold Truth.
New York Times best-selling author Roger Stone brings you Nixon's Secrets. In Nixon's Secrets, Stone reveals how the Kennedys wiretapped Nixon's hotel room the night before the Nixon-Kennedy debate and stole Nixon's medical records from his psychiatrist's office. Stone lays out how Kennedy's running mate, Lyndon Johnson, stole Texas from JFK through voter fraud, while Mayor Richard Daley stole Illinois, and how JFK actually lost the popular vote. Get Nixon's Secrets today at stonecoldtruth.com. Roger Stone, New York Times best-selling author, brings you Nixon's Secrets. Nixon's Secrets shows how Hillary Clinton was fired from the 1974 Nixon Impeachment Committee staff for lying and violating Nixon's rights, and how Hillary tried unsuccessfully to block Nixon from the Clinton White House. No wonder Nixon, upon meeting Hillary for the first time, said, "She's cold, cold as ice." Find out more at stonecoldtruth.com.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
You've been hearing Dr. Wallach talking about 90 essential nutrients, keeping the body healthy. GCNteam.com now has Beyond Tangy Tangerine tablets, 60 plant-derived minerals, 16 vitamins, 12 amino acids, packed in a powerful tablet. But that's not it. 160,000 auric points, a knockout punch to free radicals. Call 877-878-4203 or go to GCNteam.com. That's 877-878-4203.